Hello friends, this is Dr. Vishal Sood, teacher educator. In the previous lesson, we have learned about formative and summative assessment. As you know, formative assessment is carried out to improve learning among students by identifying their learning difficulties and providing remedial measures. And we have also learned about summative assessment or summative evaluation, which is carried out at the end of a particular course or at the end of the session, which is done to grade or certify the student as pass or fail or to promote him to the next class. The formative assessment is also called as assessment for learning, and summative assessment is called as assessment of learning. Now, in today's lesson, we are going to discuss about continuous and comprehensive evaluation, that is CCE. What we mean by CCE, what are its features? So, today's discussion will focus on CCE. The main points of today's discussion will be, as you can see on the screen, that is holistic personality development. What we mean by holistic personality development? Then we will discuss on need for holistic development. Then there will be a discussion on evaluation for holistic development. And then we will discuss when the evaluation should be carried out. Should it be on regular basis? Should it be on continual basis? Or should it be a single shot event? Then we will discuss about continuous and comprehensive evaluation, the concept of CCE and its nature. And in the last part of this discussion, we will deliberate on the features, the characteristics of continuous and comprehensive evaluation. So, this will be the main framework of today's lesson regarding continuous and comprehensive evaluation. So, first of all, holistic personality development. Now, what we mean by holistic personality development? Now, why we provide education to the children? What is the main aim of education? The main aim of education, as you all know, that is the overall personality development or all-round development of the personality of a child. Now, taking the child to the optimum level, as you can see on the screen, is it a teacher's task? Yes, definitely. Most of the contribution to take the child to the optimum level or his all-round personality development is in the hands of the teacher, is in the hands of the school authorities. You can see on the screen that the student is having certain inner abilities, and it is the teacher's task to nurture those, to nourish those inner abilities and grow his personality to the optimum level possible. So, personality development, it is the main aim of education, and it is the task of the teacher to develop the personality of the child to the optimum level. Now, what we mean by holistic personality development or overall personality development? There are three domains of individual's personality, and three domains of individual personality are: first is the cognitive domain of individual personality, the second is the affective domain of individual child personality, and the third is the psychomotor domain of child personality. Now, these three domains are to be developed by the teacher, and the development of all these three domains covers the holistic personality development. You can see on the screen that cognitive development, which is related to head, which is related to intellectual capacities, the mental abilities of the child. So, the holistic development includes cognitive development. That means we are interested in development of the child in terms of his mental faculties or intellectual abilities. Second is affective development, which is related to attitudes, values, habits. So, why we provide education? We provide education so that appropriate attitudes, appropriate values, social skills could be developed among the students, and this comes under the affective domain of child personality. The third is psychomotor development or the psychomotor domain. Psychomotor domain means the skill part. We provide education to the child to develop in him or her the skills required to accomplish different tasks. So, a personality of a child is developed in terms of three aspects. One is the intellectual capacities or the intellectual abilities, the attitudes, the values, the habits, and the skills or the competencies of the child to do different tasks. So this is the meaning of holistic personality development, which covers cognitive, affective, and psychomotor aspects. Then holistic development can be seen in other aspect also, that you know very well that holistic development means physical development, intellectual development, social and moral development, and emotional development. That means holistic development of a personality includes the physical development, the physique of the child. The physique of the individual should be developed in a proper manner. The intellectual development means the development of the mental abilities, the reasoning power, the critical thinking. So this is the intellectual development. Then social and moral development. This is also a part of holistic personality development, that among the students we should develop social values, moral values, attitudes, habits, so that they can be an effective and useful member of the society and contribute for the social and national development. Then another part of holistic personality development is the emotional development. Emotional development means the development of the ability among the students to handle or manage their own emotions, to manage others' emotions. So this all is a part of holistic personality development. That means holistic personality development has four aspects, or fourfold personality development means intellectual development, physical development, social and moral development, and emotional development. Now, for this holistic development, why this holistic development of the personality of child is required? There is why this is needed. This is needed for adjustment of the child to different changing circumstances. You can see on the screen that where the holistic development of personality is required for adjustment of the child to different changing circumstances in his immediate neighborhood as well as in the wider area. So how to adjust to different circumstances, how those adjustment abilities are to be developed among the students, for this holistic personality development, the social and moral values, the physical development, the intellectual development, or the development of the mental abilities are required. Then holistic personality development of the child is required to attain better quality of life. Better quality of life means a healthy and a productive life. That means in order to lead a good life, which is according to the social norms, according to the social ethics, the holistic personality development is required. What are the social norms? We should know about that. The child must have knowledge and understanding about those social norms, social ethics. So in order to lead a better and attain better quality of life, a productive life, holistic personality development of child is much essential. Then, if the child's personality is developed in all-round manner, then it will contribute towards national and social development. That means, so if the productive citizens will be there in the society, they will contribute towards the social development or to the development of their immediate community and to the society, and that will lead ultimately to the national development, which is the requirement of the current scenario. Then holistic personality development is required, as you can see on the screen, that it is required to learn and acquire desired behaviors, interests, skills, and attitudes. That means the desired behavior, the desirable behaviors which are acceptable by the society, which are acceptable by the families, which are acceptable by the school authorities, those desirable behaviors, those interests according to the child personality, the skills, the required attitude need to be developed so that the ultimate benefit can be given to the individual, to the family, to the school, to the society, and to the nation as a whole. So holistic personality development of the child is much needed to develop desirable behaviors and interests and skills and attitudes among the students. The other needs for child's personality development is to develop social values and abilities to work independently, collaboratively, and harmoniously. That means we provide education for all-round personality development, and that all-round personality development also comprises the social values development, the development of the abilities to work in an independent manner as well as in a collaborative and cooperative manner or in a harmonious manner, even if there are certain disagreements, but this skill, these values or these abilities or these attitudes must be developed among the students, that even in case of disagreements, how to work in a collaborative manner, how to work in a harmonious manner, that those abilities must be developed. And this is a part of holistic personality development. Holistic personality development is required so as to make the child aware of social and environmental issues. What are the current social issues? How those social issues can be sorted out? How those problems can be sorted out? How those environmental problems can be sorted out in order to make aware, in order to make understand about those social and environmental issues? This holistic personality development is required. Then finally, the holistic personality development of a child is required to transform that particular individual, that particular child, into a glocal personality. You can see on the screen, glocal personality means, it is glocal word, is a combination of global and local. Global in thoughts, global in actions, global in attitudes, global in interests. That means we have to develop a child, we have to develop an individual who is global in thoughts, whose thoughts are global in nature, whose actions, whose attitudes, whose interests are global in nature, but his actions and his actions in terms of solving problems and tackling different social and environmental issues should be local in nature. That means the education is provided to the child for developing into a glocal personality, global in thoughts and local in terms of actions. So this is the main requirement for holistic personality development of a child. Now, in order to assess whether the personality of the child has been developed to the utmost extent in a holistic manner or not, this must be ensured by the teacher. You, because you are a teacher, you first must know why evaluation is required. Why we are going to evaluate or assess the students? What processes constitute evaluation? In the previous lessons, we have already studied about these things, that why evaluation is required. Evaluation is required for improving the learning. Evaluation is required for improving the teaching. Evaluation is required to ascertain the efficacy and effectiveness of teaching learning process, the teaching learning methods, the teaching learning materials. Now, we have already learned about that evaluation is comprised of both measurement and assessment. Now, other question is what to evaluate, that we have already that all dimensions of holistic development of the personality. That means all dimensions of the personality of the child must be evaluated by the teacher. And these all dimensions, as we have already discussed, that these dimensions include the cognitive dimension, which is related to intellectual abilities, the affective dimension, which is related to attitudes, habits, and values, and the psychomotor domain of personality, that is related to skills and abilities of the individual. Now, another question is, how to evaluate, whether it should be a single tool or it should be a single technique to evaluate the student, or there are multi tools and techniques for evaluation. Should it be a single shot event or continual and periodic process? When to evaluate? This is the main question as a teacher in front of us, that when to evaluate the child? Should it be a single shot event? It should be carried out one time? Or should it be a continual process? Should it be a regular process, a periodic process taken at or undertaken at different points of time? So the answer to this is that evaluation should not be a single shot event. It should be conducted on continual basis. It should be conducted on regular basis. It should be conducted on periodic basis so that the flaws, so that the gaps in the learning could be identified, so that the learning can be enhanced, so that the effectiveness of the teaching learning material can be enhanced, so that it can be ascertained that whether the teaching methods or the strategies and the teaching learning materials employed by the teachers were effective, and if effective, to what extent they were effective in terms of enhancing learning among the students. So the evaluation should be continual and a periodic process. Now, when to evaluate? Continually and periodically. You can see on the screen, continually and periodically means evaluation should be conducted at regular intervals. It should not be conducted at one time only. That means it should not be a single shot event. Then another thing is evaluation of the student's knowledge, evaluation of the student's understanding, evaluation of the student's personality development should be comprehensive in nature. That means the evaluation should be multidimensional in nature. That means evaluation should cover all the domains or all the dimensions of the personality of the child. That means as a teacher, you should not only evaluate the child's knowledge and understanding. You should also evaluate what values have been inculcated among the child as a result of different activities carried out within the classroom and outside the classroom in the school campus. What skills have been developed among the students as a result of impart of knowledge, as a result of different practical activities, as a result of different co-scholastic activities or co-curricular activities organized in the school. So, the evaluation in all the domains of the personality of the child must be carried out. That means all the aspects of the personality of the child must be covered while carrying out the evaluation of the students. That means evaluation should be continuous in nature, it should be a regular feature of the teaching learning process, and it should involve all the aspects of the personality of the child. It should be multidimensional in nature. So that means evaluation should be continuous as well as comprehensive in nature. Now, what we mean by continuous and comprehensive evaluation? CCE, which is abbreviated as this, CCE, continuous and comprehensive evaluation. As we have already said, that the evaluation should be on regular basis, it should be in a continuous manner at short intervals, and it should cover all the different aspects or the four major aspects of the personality of the individual. So, continuous and comprehensive evaluation, you can see on the screen, it is a process of ensuring learning performance of students through both formative and summative evaluation in different areas such as cognitive, affective, and psychomotor to promote all-round development of the students. That means continuous and comprehensive evaluation, it is a process of ensuring learning performance. That means we wish to enhance learning among the students, and to enhance such learning among the students, we use both formative procedures as well as summative evaluation procedures. That means we do evaluation at short intervals. After teaching a particular concept, a teacher should evaluate whether the students have learned or understood that concept or not. And at the end of unit, the teacher can take a small test. It may be oral or it may be written. You have already learned about formative and summative assessment procedures in the previous lesson. So, for enhancing learning among the students through continuous and comprehensive evaluation, continuous aspect is the formative evaluation. Formative evaluation is that evaluation which is done during the formation of the knowledge, and this formation of knowledge is a continuous process. So, formative is the continuous aspect of CCE. Summative evaluation, which is done at the end to grade the student. And in the second part of this definition, you can see on the screen that formative and summative evaluation in different areas such as cognitive, affective and psychomotor. That means all the dimensions, all the aspects of child personality must be covered in CCE. That means a teacher should not only evaluate the knowledge, should not only assess the knowledge or understanding of the child in different subject areas. Rather, a teacher should also evaluate or assess the students in terms of their participation in different activities, in terms of the social values or social skills developed among them, in terms of their attitudes and habits developed among them due to different co-curricular activities or the different skills which have been developed among the students due to different practical activities or co-curricular activities. So, evaluation should be involved or carried out in terms of all the activities which are carried out within the school and outside the school and which covers all the dimensions, that is cognitive, affective and psychomotor aspects of child's personality. So this is a process of ensuring learning. That means CCE is to enhance learning among students, and for that we employ both formative evaluation procedures as well as summative evaluation procedures. And along with this, all the aspects of child's personality, all the dimensions of child's personality, cognitive, affective and psychomotor domains are covered in CCE. And this is done to achieve the aim of education, that is all-round development of the students. Then what are the features of CCE? What are the main features? What are the main characteristics of the CCE? Now you can see on the screen that the major features of CCE are, it is school-based evaluation of students covering all aspects of students' development. That means it is a school-based evaluation. CCE is carried out by the school teachers or the school authorities, and it covers all the aspects of students' personality. That means cognitive, affective and psychomotor aspects of child's personality are covered in it. That means no single aspect of child's personality is left out in CCE. That means we do not only assess the student's knowledge, understanding or skills in different subject related areas like in social sciences or in maths or in languages, but rather his level of participation in different activities, his attitude towards peers, his attitude towards teachers, his level of participation in classroom activities, his level of participation in sports activities, his level of participation in cultural activities. These all are taken into consideration under continuous and comprehensive evaluation. The continuous aspect of CCE takes care of continual and periodicity aspect of evaluation. Now, continual aspect of CCE refers to what? Continual aspect means the evaluation of the students, whether in subject related areas or in co-curricular activities, other than those subject related areas, that must be on a regular basis, that must be on a continual basis. It should not be carried out as a single shot event. As a teacher, when you teach in the class, you teach one concept, try to evaluate the student. Try to ask oral or written question so that you can know whether the students have achieved that particular learning objective or the expected learning outcome, ELOs, have been achieved or not. Then if you assess, if you come to know that yes, students have now understood about this thing, they have learned about this concept, move to the next concept. And then after teaching of that next concept, again evaluate or assess the student's knowledge about that particular concept. And in this way, you can move to the next part, which is known as the continuous part of the CCE. Periodicity aspect of evaluation means it should be conducted at regular intervals also. That means monthly tests, half yearly tests or annual examinations. So that means CCE includes both the formal mechanism as well as the informal mechanism. Through formal mechanism, we try to evaluate what learning has taken place among the students and where the learning gaps are still existing. And in CCE also covers the summative evaluation, the evaluation carried out after a certain period, after 6 months or at the end of the session, that is done to grade or certify the students. That means CCE covers both. It should be continual, it should be periodic in nature. Continual means, as you can see on the screen, continual means assessment of students in the beginning of instructions. That is known as placement evaluation. That means at the time of initial of the session or the beginning of the session, the students' evaluation should be or assessment should be carried out. Now, why this should be carried out? This should be carried out to know what the previous knowledge or past experiences are with the students. This helps you as a teacher. This helps you to know the starting point where from where you can start your teaching learning process. And this sort of evaluation is known as placement evaluation. Then assessment during the instructional process. That means after teaching a small part or a small concept, you should evaluate the student. And such sort of evaluation is known as formative evaluation. About this concept, we have already discussed, deliberated in the previous lesson. So, assessment which is carried out during the instructional process at regular intervals after the completion of smaller concepts or the facts, that is known as formative evaluation. And it is may be done informally or it may be done formally using multiple techniques of evaluation. You can ask oral questions, you can give written question, you can assign some activity, you can assign some project. So these are all are the techniques of formative evaluation. So continual means instruction, the evaluation carried out at the beginning of the teaching learning process, the evaluation carried out during the instructional process, and evaluation carried out at the end of the instructional process. It may be carried out at the end of a particular period, at the end of a particular chapter. It can be carried out at the end of a unit. So this is the continual aspect which includes formative evaluation. Then continuous evaluation. You can see on the screen that what are the features of continuous evaluation. First is frequency of unit testing. Frequency of unit testing means in this evaluation, CCE, the unit tests are conducted at frequent intervals. There is regularity of assessment. You can see on the screen, the unit tests are conducted at frequent intervals at the end of a unit, at the end of a chapter. So this is the regularity in assessment. Then on the basis of this, we try to diagnose the learning gaps in CCE. Another feature of continuous aspect of evaluation. What are the learning difficulties? What are the learning gaps of the student? We try to diagnose, we try to identify those learning difficulties, those learning gaps among the students. This is one of the features of the continuous aspect of CCE. Then, on the basis of that diagnosis, we try to provide the corrective measures or we try to provide the feedback to the students, so that they can improve upon their learning difficulties, so that they can correct their mistakes, so that they can correct their errors. So, diagnosis of learning difficulties, use of corrective measures, and provision of feedback. These all are the features of continuous aspect of CCE. Another feature of CCE is retesting. That means if a student is not able to understand or learn a particular concept in your class and you identify his or her learning difficulties, and after providing the corrective measures or remedial measures or feedback to the students, there is a provision of retesting. That means you again test that student after providing him corrective measures or after providing him feedback, you again test that student and try to assess whether the student has learned the concept, understood the concept after provision of corrections or feedback or not. So there is a provision of retesting in CCE under its continuous aspects. So these are the characteristics or the features of continuous aspect of evaluation, that is frequently the unit tests or tests at the end of the chapters are conducted. There is regularity of assessment, the identification of learning gaps is there. There is provision of feedback and remedial measures, and there is provision of retesting in CCE. Then the comprehensive component, the other word in CCE is comprehensive. Comprehensive component of CCE takes care of assessment of all-round development of child's personality. It includes assessment in scholastic as well as co-scholastic aspects of students' growth. That means the assessment of students' growth or students' personality should not be in terms of merely the subject knowledge or the subject understanding. That means all the domains of the personalities or all the dimensions of child personality must be evaluated, must be assessed by the teacher. That means to what extent the student is participating in different classroom activities, to what extent the participation level of the student was there in different sports related activities or cultural activities or other co-academic activities which are organized in the school. So the participation level of the student in these activities, what attitude he possesses towards his school, what attitude he possesses towards his elders, what attitude or values he possesses towards his peer group, all these are taken into consideration and these are given weightage in the assessment of child's personality. So this is the comprehensive component of CCE, the second C, which refers to comprehensiveness. That means not merely the evaluation in subject knowledge or subject understanding should be carried out, rather in different areas, in different activities of the school, the student's participation, student's contribution, his social skills, his social values, his moral values, his habits, the cleanliness status, the hygienic status maintained by the student, all these are taken into consideration, which forms the part of comprehensiveness in evaluation. Scholastic aspect. Now, as we already said, comprehensive includes two aspects, scholastic and co-scholastic. Scholastic aspects, as you can see on the screen, it includes subject-specific areas, whereas co-scholastic aspects include personal social qualities, personal hygiene, personal cleanliness, values, social skills, then participation in co-curricular activities, the attitude towards the school, attitude towards the teachers, attitude towards the parents, attitude towards the peers, all these are covered under the co-scholastic aspect, which is an aspect of comprehensiveness in evaluation. Now, comprehensive evaluation, as you can see on the screen, what areas are covered in under comprehensiveness in evaluation? You can see on the screen that knowledge, understanding, application ability, analysis ability or analytical abilities, evaluation or judgmental abilities, creativity, all these are covered in comprehensiveness nature of evaluation. That is a part of CCE. That means in CCE, we try to assess the knowledge, we try to assess the understanding of the student in different subject related areas. We also try to assess his application ability, the knowledge or understanding which he or she has gained, to what extent he is successful in applying that knowledge and understanding. What are the analytical abilities are possessed by the child? These are also taken in consideration while evaluating the student's personality. Then the decision making power or the judgmental power of the student, they are also a part of CCE. The creativity of the student, the critical thinking of the student, this all is a part of comprehensive nature of the evaluation. That means the comprehensive nature of evaluation includes three things, that is the thinking skills are also taken into consideration, they are also assessed. The emotional skills of the students, they are also assessed. The social skills are also assessed. That means comprehensiveness means the evaluation of the student in all areas and not only or merely in the subjects, just like mathematics, English, social sciences, EVS or the other. So evaluation should be, it should be comprehensive, it should have a wider scope, it should be widely in related to all the aspects which are, or all the activities which are carried out in the school. So continue, and it should be on a continual basis, it should be on a regular basis. So continuous and comprehensive evaluation means the carrying out evaluation of the student on a continual, on a regular, on a periodic basis, and in all areas of or all dimensions of child's personality. That is the part of CCE, continuous and comprehensive aspect. You can see on the screen, comprehensiveness in evaluation includes cognitive abilities, affective abilities, as well as psychomotor abilities and skills. Cognitive abilities, affective abilities, and psychomotor skills are the part of comprehensiveness in evaluation. These are the three dimensions or the domains of child's personality, which is termed as holistic personality development, which we have discussed in the initial part of today's lesson. Now, aspects covered in CCE, that is, the scholastic aspects are also covered. That means subject-related aspects, mathematics, science, languages, EVS, all these aspects, the knowledge, the understanding, the application ability of the student in these subject-related areas are covered in CCE. In addition to these scholastic aspects, the co-scholastic aspects are also given weightage in CCE. And this co-scholastic aspects are related to the comprehensiveness feature of CCE. Now, what we have discussed in today's lesson, we discussed about the meaning of holistic personality development, what we mean by the all-round personality development, and why there is need for holistic personality development of the child. We discussed about these things in detail. Then we discussed about the CCE, that is continuous and comprehensive evaluation, what we mean by continuous and comprehensive evaluation. Then we deliberated on the aspects, those are the scholastic aspects and the co-scholastic aspects of CCE. We discussed about the features of CCE. Those features are that it should be continuous, it should be regular, and this should be carried out to improve the learning among the students, to identify the learning gaps, and to provide the remedial measures. So this was the total framework of today's lesson, about which we have discussed in detail. Friends, I hope that you have understood about the CCE and its aspects and its features in a better way. Thank you very much.